So hello everybody, welcome to the YouTube channel. In this video, we'll be talking about the Warren Buffett's letter to his shareholders 2020. If you see, the letter is of around 14 pages, but you don't need to read it. I'm going to state to you 5 important points that is going to cover the entire letter to you, and you'll be able to understand how this great person actually thinks, and will be able to take values from him and hopefully apply them in your future. So let's begin with the video. Point number 1. Warren Buffett talked about the financials of Berkshire Hathaway itself. He stated that one of the most important metrics, that is operating earnings, went down by 9%, but the operating profit for the fourth quarter went up by 23%. But we should also keep in mind that the overall market rallied in the fourth quarter, which caused the operating profit of the fourth quarter of Berkshire Hathaway also to increase significantly. Point number 2. Every year Buffett talks about his holdings, in which this year Apple made it to the list. He stated that he holds around 5.5% of Apple's stake, and he also stated that the buyback that Apple made was a very good move, and which increased his earning per share also in the long run eventually, and also increased his stake in the company. So he was very much happy with the decision of the Apple company itself for the buyback, which eventually helps the shareholders to earn more by eventually increasing the EPS. Point number 3. In this part, he accepted his mistakes, and he also stated that the investment he made in PPC was a wrong one, in which he paid too much for a company, and he had to pay the price for it. He also stated that this was not one of his first mistakes. In fact, he made many others, but this was a big one. Point number 4. In this part, he stated that Berkshire Hathaway is not like any normal conglomerate. A conglomerate is a company which takes on businesses which are very different from each other. But Berkshire Hathaway is not like any normal conglomerate, because any normal conglomerate would like to take the full control of any business, but good companies whose management doesn't want to sell out won't be taken on by this conglomerate, so they will be losing a very good opportunity. But Berkshire Hathaway is not like them, so if they feel that this company has good potential, the financials are good, the management is good, they believe in that company, then they take non-controlling power of that company, take entry in that company, and so therefore they become different from those conglomerates, because they are willing to take non-controlling power in a company and make a huge investment in that. Point number 5. In this point, Warren clearly stated that don't bet against America. The American dream is still alive. America has faced a few issues in the past, but they are still one of the leading, not the top country in the world. So the American dream is still alive. So don't bet against America. The words of Warren Buffett. So I've come to the end of the 5-point analysis. So whoever saw the video till the end, I would like to share a bonus point for you guys and state Mr. Warren Buffett himself in his letter. He stated that investing illusion can continue for a surprisingly long time. The Wall Street loves the fees that the deal making generates, and the press loves the stories that colorful promoters provide. At a point, also the soaring price of a promoter's stock can itself become the proof that the illusion is in fact true. Eventually, of course, the party ends, and the business emperors are found to have with no clothes, and those business or businesses become just business junkyard. So I don't know whom he is pointing towards, but if you have any idea, you guys, you can put it in the comment section. So that's all for the video. I hope you liked it. If you did like it, then do hit the like button. If you're not yet subscribed, do subscribe to the channel. This is me, Ankur Mazumdar, signing out. Peace out.